What's going on? I'm Kevin Hart, and this is season 4, Cold as Balls, The Bubble. Ha! In your face, NBA.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Meet me right
here. Wait a minute. Wait.
Okay. Okay, Kevin. Oh, damn.
Yeah. That's enough. I'm tired. Take this stuff. It should have been a lot. Give me a second. It should have been a lot faster and smoother. Guys, why did we practice?
Get your asses out.
Ryan.
Garcia,
oh, how are you, man?
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you, man. God, look at this guy's face, man. How old are you, Ryan?
22,
my
13. 13.
Now we really gotta fight.
Well, I don't want no trouble. I don't want no trouble. I come in peace.
All right, take your robe off, throw it over there to the side. I can't believe I got Ryan Garcia on Cold as Balls. So long overdue, man.
Man.
Flash.
See that, clap. Speed mine up in post.
Come on, Kevin.
Yeah.
Dish, I'm an uppercut because you're short.
Yeah.
Dish, oh wait, I gotta get lower.
No.
Dish.
Well, he's had enough. Come on, Ryan.
Thanks,
Kevin. Get in, we'll sit on the edge. Careful, it's probably cold. You don't learn. Yep.
Welcome to all new episode of Cold as Balls. Today, we got none other than Ryan Garcia. Flash.
Yes.
Flash.
Thank you for having me. It's such a surreal moment for me. Like, I watch you on movies, I watch all that, and I'm just like, man, this is crazy. It's just a blessing, you know?
Boxing, no, man. Amazing. I can say the same thing right back at you. I'm a big fan.
Yeah.
I follow boxing, and your journey thus far is unreal. 20-0, man. How's that feel?
It feels great, you know? Coming from Victorville, California, small town, you know, nothing really going out there, and just making it to where I am right now it gives me more motivation to keep pushing.
Let's go to the beginning. Why boxing?
So I was around 7 years old. I was playing baseball. And I mean, they were telling me I was gonna be the next Babe Ruth.
Really?
Yeah, and then my team was just kind of failing me. And as a kid, I was so frustrated. I was like, is there any sports that's one-on-one? And then my uncle was like, well, there's this thing called boxing. I didn't even know what it was. And then, you know, they put the gloves on me. And once I started punching, I felt like invincible. And I felt like this is really what I want. And it's one-on-one. So I don't have to rely on anybody.
Mm-hmm.
So if I lose, it's because of me, and if I win, it's because of me.
Here's what's most interesting to me. You got a blueprint in front of you. There's so many that have come before us, so you can kind of make a decision as to what path you want to go down. In boxing, who's that person for you?
I would say Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. Why?
Just because he stood for something more than boxing.
Mm.
And he always stood up for himself and what he believed in. And then just doing amazing things in the ring. I want to do like Mike Tyson type stuff. Mm-hmm. I want to knock people out cold. I want to sleep the guy on the floor like I did my last fight.
When you say Mike Tyson, right, and you just say do the things he did, are you referring to ears, eating ears?
I think everything besides eating ears. Just the knockouts,
How do you prepare for a fight, man? Like, how do you get pumped up?
I like worship music when I'm about to fight or when I'm training. It just puts me in like a vibe where I don't know, it just gets me hyped up.
I get it. You know, for me, to get pumped up, I sometimes just use Old Spice Sweat Defense. It's not an ad. Old Spice Sweat Defense makes me feel unstoppable.
It's not an ad.
Nope. I think the best thing that we should... But Bam, I don't understand why you don't grasp the concept of time. Bam, why are you breathing like that? Okay. Go get some water and come back. Matter of fact, Bam, it's your choice to come back. If you need to take a nap, you can. I'm sorry, Ryan. COVID! Guys, turn me down! Just give me a second, Ryan. I just want to make sure you're protected here. All right, let's get it. Do the thing that we worked on.
You got a procedure.
Yeah, just give me the last big spray, guys, if you could. There you go. Okay, Bam, that's too far. It's gone. It's going. And I'll tell you what, next time, how about you get here on time?
Let's go to level 2 already.
Yep. Nope, let's do it, man.
Do you cold tub at all?
I do a lot.
You do?
Ooh. Right.
Still okay. Cold every time, though.
Never gets better.
Hey, get all the way in.
Yeah,
I'm already in.
I dive.
Then dive right now.
I'm about to. That's why I said you got to give me a second. Mine's a little more dangerous the way that I do it. Let me just, before I...
What are you doing?
Get out. Get your ass out. Why would you do that right now?
You gotta get in before I... Literally, I'm gonna punch you now.
Okay,
I'm tired of it.
You don't think I'm gonna get in this?
You haven't done it. You say you dive, you do all this.
Because everything has to be dramatic. I make it dramatic. Watch the entrance. Trust me, it's gonna be like smoking everything. It's gonna be crazy.
Get in!
I'm about to get in.
I'm freezing here.
Right, you gotta stop raising your voice. That's a lawsuit.
I'll show you a lawsuit.
My human resource department is the best in the world. And I wanna bring out Kathy. Is Kathy here? Kathy? I'm so... Bam. Put it up. Go. Go. Y'all in the back watching Rocky? Is that what's setting all this off? Cut the TV off. For the entire crew, no TV in the bubble. Unless it's a Kevin Hart movie. So, you got Ride Along 1, 2, About Last Night.
Big Mama's House?
That's not my movie, Rye. So give me a second. Jumanji.
Half-Baked?
It's not my movie, Rye.
The Pimp Chronicles?
What the f*** is your problem, man? What, do you even know who I am? Nobody's watching my movies either. Forget it, nothing.
I'm sorry, man, but I love Friday.
If you wasn't a professional, I would come over there and kick your ass.
Get in the tub.
Yeah.
All right. I'm freezing here.
Okay, well, we'll figure it out. I know that you were working with Canelo's trainer, right?
I believe he's the best trainer in the world.
Of course, and that has to be a fact, because you're 22.
Yep.
Real quick, Canelo, what's your relationship like with him?
We got the best relationship. Really? We might not, you know, have the same language. He speaks Spanish, but man, we get along so good.
Looking for advice, because I've been getting strong recommendations. I'm curious to know, how do you feel about my boxing style, Ryan?
Oh, I think that...
It's kind of weird. Weird deep breath there. I don't know if anybody else picked up on that.
You had some athleticism in you, for sure. I think you could have
been... Weird laugh I'm sensing in the middle of all of that. It's kind of...
All right, we're going all the way in now.
I'm in there. Let's do it. No, I'm serious. It's cold. It's cold as You cold? Yeah. I know you cold, because I'm cold. Ooh. Oh, man.
Once it hits that chest, it's over.
I'm gonna go ahead and get in here now.
Oh, what are you doing?
Getting in, buddy.
Oh, I'm all the way in.
Here I go. So.
No, nah, stop playing.
No, when we talk about
he's been dodging
my
this
fighting stop.
Suck.
I know I'm not a boxer, I'm just saying, like, do you see anything? I
don't see shit.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Not pretty hurtful, right?
Not an ounce of talent in the boxing ring. I'm coming out. I'm
okay.
Too cold. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you.
Here we
now.
Go.
Look, I got something for you.
Okay.
Since you've been getting on my nerve.
Yeah. Yeah, I got it.
It's called the body shot challenge.
Okay.
So we're gonna put this on you.
Huh.
And I basically punch you till you can't get punched on me.
Oh.
So we're gonna start off by putting this on you.
Oh. What's it called?
It's called the body shot challenge.
Oh, that sounds dope. Put it on Daryl. Daryl does a lot of this stuff for me.
You sure you want Daryl to do it?
Yeah, Daryl.
I kind of want you to do it.
I know, but Daryl does a lot of this stuff for me. It's gonna be cool.
Let's go, Daryl. Why does Daryl look so scared right now?
I don't know, Daryl. Daryl, you're gonna be fine. I was acting like a bitch.
Where's our gloves at?
Yeah, you got gloves? Give him a left hand. Oh, there you go.
Ooh,
yeah, give him a left hand.
Damn,
yeah.
You are the best, man.
Right, before you do this, I wanna let you know something. Daryl has been training for quite some time. So I'm gonna do it after you, Daryl, so you just go ahead.
You're next, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna picture your face on this.
There you go, go ahead,
that's
I'm going next.
All right, let's start.
Oh, man. Okay, that's enough. Well, Bam, I ain't never seen you jump in front of me one time. All right, okay. What a day. I just don't know what is happening right now.
So I gotta get back in here.
Okay. Well. When's your next fight?
I've actually already started training camp.
You started training camp. Are you excited about this fight? What will this fight mean to you if you win?
This fight was gonna be the biggest fight of my life so far.
The biggest fight of your life so far.
This is gonna put me on, you know, that level where I get that respect. I think this fight will solidify me as probably one of the best in the world right now.
Those lights are gonna get bigger
your stages are about to get busy.
Right.
I was at our little pandemic bubble bar, and I heard a lot of talk about Campbell possibly beating you. I didn't say nothing. I definitely heard some people that were saying it. I don't know what you would do if you knew who said it. Boy, I can only imagine the type of bam that would go down.
Bam, you got anything you want to tell me?
Can't see now, huh?
Well, I know I'm gonna beat Luke Campbell and knock him out within 3 rounds. And I'm very, very, very sure of that, 100% sure, so. Come at me.
I got your back, buddy.
Got it.
Hey, Luke, you punk bitch. I'm Ryan Garcia's mental. I'm in his head, and guess what? I just got myself a bowl of cereal, and I don't have any milk, which means I'm gonna crunch it all day. That's right. That's me whooping your ass, Luke. You don't want me to get loose.
Yeah. Just for clarity, Luke, just for clarity, I'm talking trash as Ryan, okay?
It's not me.
Yeah, whatever. I don't know how I think of it. Ryan, TikTok.
Yes.
Your numbers are getting big, man.
Yeah.
You did something with Tekashi69 on TikTok.
Yeah.
How did that come about?
I don't know how that came about. I literally walked into a house and he was there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
An informant.
And then Ryan. He snitched on me.
All right, yeah. What are we talking about? Doesn't matter. I've heard you speak on anxiety and your ups and downs with it. Tell me just where you are with anxiety now.
I think I've learned how to cope with it a little better. Mm-hmm. And, you know, dealing with it, my biggest thing was I couldn't talk about it because I felt like I was going to be judged or mm-hmm. somebody was going to look down on me. But once I started talking about it, I felt way better. And then I just felt myself becoming a stronger person. So I think if kids could talk about it sooner rather than later, it could really help them in life.
I mean, I love the fact that you're 22 years old and you're having this type of conversation. That's so dope.
Definitely.
Makes me happy to hear.
Okay, so I got some questions for you.
Yep.
What's my fastest knockout?
7 seconds. 7 seconds. 7 seconds. Do we even know the answer yet?
Kevin, it's not 7 seconds, Kevin.
See my fastest knockout.
It's 30 seconds, Kevin.
Oh my God, I forgot the minus the 23.
How many knockouts do I have in my pro career?
Easy, 14 knockouts.
Kevin, do you?
Yeah.
Do you even care?
How many is it? What are you talking
about? 17.
Will you stop? First of all, let me finish saying what I was saying. 14 knockouts, but three of them were ones that people weren't sure because guys took a weird knee and it could have went, and that's where I got the. Yep, that's
oh.
it.
Oh,
yeah. Boom. That, bam, he didn't even get any wrong. Okay.
What the?
Yeah. Oh. I don't know what his problem is, and I suggest you deal with that on your own. At the end of the day, we're in the bubble.
What's my nickname?
I know that. Flash. That's right.
Oh! Oh! Woo! Woo! All right, I'm gonna teach you a little something.
Oh, wait. Before you teach me something, let me put an end to the episode, just in case what you show me is bad.
I'm gonna have Bam as my trainer.
Yeah.
You have Daryl. And we could spar in the middle of this this field.
I like it.
Let's
I like
go.
It.
Come on.
All right, so look, we'll spar right here. Okay. Here's what we're gonna do. Ryan, we're gonna go right here in the middle. Are my boxer shoes out here? Bam, you see my boxer shoes? Right, I'll be right back. Let me get my boxer shoes. I'll be right back. Oh, you better save it, because I'm gonna whoop your ass when I come back. No, just give me a second. Run, Daryl! Run, Daryl!